Good evening. I'm Sonia Burke coming to you live from the studios of Montgomery Community Media, where we're covering primary election day in Montgomery County. The polls are going to close in just a few minutes at 8 p.m., and that's when our primary election coverage really takes off. We'll be live through 11 p.m. as we report the results as they are released from the Board of Elections. Standing by, it's been a long day for the candidates and their supporters. The polls opened at 7 a.m. today, and now as they get ready to close at 8, everybody wants to know, when will we get those first results? Standing by live at the Board of Elections office is Michael Bruin. Michael, when do we expect to receive that first batch of election results?
Hi, Sonia. I'm here at the Board of Elections with Margie Rohr, who's just been working like a dog all day long. I don't know how you do this every 2 years. I really, really don't. But now that we're coming up to 8 o'clock, it might be useful if you tell people there's a lot of work that will now start to happen. So what's going on?
Absolutely. Right now we're doing the final pieces of the tabulation of the early voting results. We should have those ready to go up on the website and release them to the public within the next 15, 20 minutes. And then, of course, the polling places close at 8 o'clock. Anybody who is in line at 8 will still have an opportunity to vote, but once all of the voters have voted, then the judges will begin closing down the precinct. That takes about 45 minutes to an hour, and then they'll start modeming the results into us here at the Board of Elections.
Now, so most of the precincts can modem the data in, but then they pack everything up and they bring those memory cards here, and it's kind of a great shot. We're going to try to catch it again this year. But it really is Grand Central Station.
It absolutely. We have two judges from every precinct, so that's 255. Now, they're all in one car, so it's not really bad. We have 255 cars coming in here with the critical materials, the memory cards, the provisional ballots, and the other critical materials. They'll queue up behind our building, and they'll drop everything off at certain stages along the way, and we'll be going and we'll be accepting everything obviously until everybody gets here, so we'll be going pretty late tonight.
And just, I'm curious, so with the modems coming in, it's not till tomorrow that you verify the memory cards, right? Is that what it becomes like? Official results take a few days?
Official results actually take a couple of weeks, because remember, the official results will include the absentee and provisional ballots, don't get counted until next week.
Okay.
What we do tonight is we verify that all of the modem cards have been uploaded to the server, and once we do that, then tomorrow we'll do a 100% verification to make sure all the numbers match. So there's many checks and balances along the way to make sure that everybody's vote got counted, and that we're releasing the accurate results when we release them.
And you are here at the crack of dawn today, and you're here until, I don't know, 1 or whatever, and then you're back tomorrow morning.
Yeah, let's hope for 1 o'clock. I will be here till the last results are up on the website, and then tomorrow probably by 9:30 maybe, but I'll be back.
Well, Margie, thanks for giving us some of your time.
Sure,
and
thank you.
We'll try to get you to come again.
I'll be here.
All right, live from the Board of Elections, I'm Michael Bruin. Back to you guys.
Thank you, Michael and Marjorie. Joining me now in the studio for a recap of the primary election season and a preview of what we might expect to see tonight is communications consultant Steve Simon. Steve, what are you thinking today as we hear voter turnout is low?
Hey, Sonia. Well, it is low, but if I could, I want to talk first about this issue of the results. Just, I think it's funny for a lot of people that have not been watching elections for a long time. We used to know unequivocally the results of elections about 8:05 when they used to do the noon vote, and I always find it interesting. Here we are in the age of the internet, and it takes us until much later in the evening to know. We really get those early voting results, which is kind of the equivalent of the old days getting a noon vote, but not nearly as accurate, not nearly as much. So I find that fascinating, just listening to that first part. But yeah, so far we're hearing low turnout, the June primary, and it's a surprise to a lot of people that there's an election still going on right now.
What do you think a low turnout's going to mean to the incumbents and their challengers? Who does it benefit?
Well, I don't know. I mean, we saw recently in Virginia a case where they said early election, low turnout, and there was sort of an earthquake election there, if you will, in the upset of Representative Cantor, in Virginia. So I don't know what it means, but sometimes let's say it's really about get out the vote, and sometimes it can benefit the opponents.
What other race are you watching today?
So we're watching county executive race. I mean, this time, the first time we have three major candidates, if you will, in the Democratic race for county executive. That's huge this year. Obviously watching other races like the governor's race. And I think not just what's going to happen statewide, but we're always curious about the results in Montgomery County. We have two candidates from Montgomery County, and the question is, can they hold, either one of them hold their own county in that? For me, I'm kind of strange, so I'd say several elections are interesting. Watching the county council races and other things, but when I talk to my neighbors, I wish they were paying attention too, but I don't see it.
Yeah, with the low voter turnout. Let's go back to the county executive race. Mm-hmm. You've got our incumbent, Ike Leggett, mm-hmm. challenged by Doug Duncan and Phil Andrews. What are people telling you? Who do you think is his main challenger?
Very close. I mean, you're looking at a possibility where it almost looks like a co-incumbents type race. Doug Duncan served for 12 years. Ike Leggett has been county executive for 8 years. And Phil Andrews is saying, you know, you've had 20 years of them. It's time for a change. So it's a very interesting election. You have experienced candidates across the board. I think anything can happen in it. I think we're going to be waiting for these results here. I think it can be very close. You hear a little bit about whether there's a Phil Andrews surge towards the end, and what does that surge mean if that's true. But really, none of this is based on a lot of polling that people really are seeing results. I think if you talk to people in any of the camps, there's a lot of fingers crossed and not a lot of real information.
The first results we're going to get are going to be from early voting. Mm-hmm. Who do you think had the biggest turnout during that time period?
I think it's hard to say, but I think that we know that there was a few. It was a little bit more exercise this time. Early voting is still new. We counted more votes. I think it was a little over 17 or 18,000 or something like that. So we know it's up. I think that every candidate would probably, you know, say that they made an effort to get their workers out, especially out for the early voting.
How telling are those first batch of results in your previous history watching elections?
That's what I was saying about the part before. We used to have this thing called the noon box. And what would happen is throughout the county, they would take all the precincts, all the votes, all morning through noon. And they would count those and they would release those results at 8:05 p.m. That was a snapshot of the entire county, every actual precinct, not like early voting, which happens at specially set up precincts that are not really the permanent precincts that are set up. And it was a much larger count, so you had a more accurate. So I think we can get a pretty good indication, but I don't think anybody's going to say after we look at the early voting results, unless it's absolutely a blowout, that we know the answers.
Gotcha. Well, it's going to be interesting to watch tonight.
Yes.
We're on the edge of our seat. Thank you for joining us. We hope to hear from you more in the next hour. Again, our early voting results will be back in the next hour. Joining me on a panel will be the moderator of 21 This Week, Casey Aiken, former Montgomery County Council member Mike Knapp, and the president and CEO of the Gaithersburg Germantown Chamber of Commerce, Marilyn Balcom. Our coverage of primary election day in Montgomery County is just getting started. Don't go away. Susan Kennedy leads our extended Vote 2014 coverage when we come right back. I'm Sonia Burke. Thank you for watching.